friends, welcome back. My name is Priyendra Kumar and today we will learn how to create these ultimate speedometer in Microsoft Excel. So as you are seeing my screen, I have created this in Microsoft Excel. And friends, to creating these speedometer, I haven't used any kind of image, picture, or even I have not used any kind of graph, neither pie graph, donut graph, nothing. So I have just created these speedometer by using the shapes, and I have connected with this data by using simple macro code. Okay, so I'll tell you today how can you create this speedometer in Microsoft Excel. So let's start. So I'm going to insert a new worksheet here and I will copy this data and we'll paste it here. So first of all, friend, we will create the first speedometer for service level. So I'll tell you from the starting how can you use the shapes and which shapes to be used to create this speedometer. Okay, so first of all, we will create this dial. So I'll insert a simple oval here by pressing shift key, and now I'll go to the shape fill and I will fill as no fill. Now I'll go to the shape outline and I will take the shape outline as this one blue, or we can take this one, this blue. Now right click, go to the format shape, and in lines we will take the width of line as 15. Now we will go to the effects, and under 3D format we will take top evil as the first one, which is circle. So our dial is ready. Now we will create this inner circle, the yellow one. Okay, to creating that, I will again insert a oval and I'll drag it here by pressing shift key. We will keep it like that. Now I'll use the shape fill as the light color. I'm taking this one. Now right click, go to the format shape, and I'll change the transparency as 40% or 50%. For the line, I'll take the color as this one, which is the orange. Now the width as take 2. Okay friends, now we will create this arc. So I'll keep it here, keep it here. We'll use these shapes later on. So first of all, I'll insert a shape, which is the block arc. So create, click on this and just drag it here. Let me just adjust this yellow sign and make change the width of this arc. Now you can change the size of it like that. Okay friend, so we can try to keep in this, and now we can change the size like that. So we also need to change the width. Now we can keep it here. now we will fill the color here. So first of all, I'll remove the outline. So I'll select no outline. Now we are creating for this blue theme, that's why we'll take the related color. So I'll go to the format save, and here I'll select the this one gradient fill. Now I'll remove this stop 2, and in stop 1 I'll take the blue color, and stop 2 I'll take the yellow color, and here in place of radial we can take linear, and here I'll select this one which is linear left. Okay, now I'll change the transparency as 50%, and same for the blue one as 50%. Okay friends, so now we will create the so first of all I'll create this glossy wall here. So I'll insert one more oval, and we will change the size it as 0.5 and here 0.5, and we'll remove the outline for this also, and go to the format save, and we will fill the gradient fill. In gradient fill we'll take the white and blue, and here we'll select the so first of all we'll remove the transparency, this one also. Now we can select the second as lighter blue, and first is, or we can choose the color from here also. So we can take this one. Okay friends, so it's looking like a 3D wall. We can change the width and height. It's looking like a 3D wall. So we can give a sign here like that. So we can insert one more oval, and we can put it here. So let me zoom my screen so that you can view it properly. Now we will remove the outline for this also. Now here we will again fill the gradient fill, and we will use the white color here, white, and second one also white. Now we'll change the transparency as the 100%, and for the second white we'll take as 20% or 30%. Okay, now it will look like a 3D shape. Okay, now we'll create this shadow here. So to creating a shadow we'll take again one more oval, a small oval like this. You can keep it here. Now we'll remove the outline. Now right click and go to the format save, and we will again fill it, fill the color as gradient fill. Now this time we will take in gradient fill first as black, and second is of course white, and the type we will choose as path. So it's looking like a small shadow. You can keep it here. Okay friends, so now So now we will create this needle and these numbers and indicators. So we'll insert a shape, this one, this triangle. Okay, so in from the basic shapes, click and click here. I will change the size and the width so that it can look like a needle. So let me select this ball and shadow, and we can make it group so then we can move it anywhere. First of all, I'll remove the outline from this needle and will change the color as blue with the matching theme color. Okay. Now we will rotate this by using the macro. So right click, go to the format shape, and we can rotate this from here from the size and position, and in size rotate. We can give a angle here. But friends, when we will rotate this, just look at this, then the position of this size is also getting changed. Okay, so we cannot rotate it like that. So we will use a trick here, I'll tell you. So first keep it here. Like that. Okay, now what I will do, I'll keep it here and make another copy of this, and I will rotate this on 180 degree. So we will rotate it 180 degree in twice. First I'll rotate right 90, then again rotate 90, and I'll keep it here. So let me zoom it. We will keep it here like that, then select another one and just make it group. Now if I will rotate, then I can use this one. So the center point will not change now, so we can use this like that. Okay, now what I will do, I'll keep it here. So first of all, I'll select the second needle and go to the format, and I'll fill it as no fill. Now it will look like a single needle, but actually it is two needle. Okay, and we have make it group. Now we can keep it here. Okay, right click and go to the format shape. And in format save, we'll go to the size and properties, and we'll check the rotation degree or rotation angle is 0. Now we can rotate it like 20 degree, 30 degree or whatever. So then the center point will not change. So now I'll check if I will keep it on 100% like this. Then what will be the degree of the angle? It will be approximately 243. Now let me check on 0. So it has removed from the center point. So now what we will do, we'll change the size. Okay, now 243 or 244, actually 248. Okay, 0 to 248. So it will move 0 to 248, to moving from 0 to 100%. Okay, so when our actual value will be 100%, then the needle should be rotate on 248 degree. Okay friends, so now we will keep this in mind while creating the codes or anything. So we have to maximum it should be rotate on 248 degree. Okay, so now first of all we will create the indicators here. So how we will create the indicator? will insert a line here and just drag here, and we can change the line color of the line as black, not this one, and we will keep it here like that. Okay friends, now we will use few macro code to check where our line should be placed, and we will create few other macro code to rotate this needle automatically in my next part of this video. So please watch the next part of this video to understand the better how to create this speedometer. Thank you so much for the watching.